Hello friends, today we'll discuss about Parkinson's disease, which is also known as paralysis agitans. Parkinson's disease cause. It is due to widespread destruction of the portion of the substantia nigra, mainly pars compacta. This pars compacta sends dopaminergic nerve fibers to the caudate nucleus and putamen that we have already discussed, nigrostriatal pathway. Characteristic features of Parkinson's disease. There are three cardinal signs, and they are rigidity of most of the muscles of the body. Second, that is tremors. These tremors, they are present when the person is resting. Therefore, the tremors are known as resting tremors. And at a rate of 3 to 6 cycles per second. Also, person is having difficulty in initiating movement, which is known as akinesia. Therefore, cardinal signs of Parkinson's disease, they are rigidity, tremors and akinesia or hypokinesia. It is also associated with postural instability because of impaired postural reflexes. Therefore, person cannot maintain balance and person falls down. As well as other features are dysphagia, impaired ability to swallow. Also, the person is having speech disorders, gait disturbances and fatigue. Parkinson's disease, both hypokinetic as well as hyperkinetic features, they can be observed. Hypokinetic features are akinesia and bradykinesia, and hyperkinetic features are rigidity and tremors. There is also absence of motor activity, and there is difficulty in initiating voluntary movements. There is decrease in the automatic associated movements. For example, swinging of arms during walking, facial expressions related to emotional content of thought as well as speech. Here, in hyperkinetic feature, there is rigidity. Laid pipe type of rigidity is observed. Rigidity is different from spasticity because in rigidity, there is increased motor neuronal discharge to both agonist as well as antagonist muscle. The rigidity is known as laid pipe rigidity because the resistance is felt like we are bending a laid pipe while performing passive movement. Sometimes there is a series of catches present during passive movement, which is known as cogwheel rigidity. But there is sudden loss of resistance seen in the spastic extremity that is absent here. Tremors present, they are at rest and they disappear with activity. It is due to regular alternating 8 to 10 hertz contractions of antagonist muscle. Parkinson's disease is a neurodegenerative disease. Now, this is, we have already discussed, diagrammatic representation of connections of basal ganglia. Here, what is the cause of Parkinson's disease? It is due to loss of dopaminergic fibers in the nigrostriatal pathway, substantia nigra to corpus striatum. Either there is loss of dopaminergic fibers or due to loss of the dopamine receptors in the basal ganglia. Which are the causes of Parkinson's disease? Parkinson's disease, it is resulting from a complication of influenza. This was epidemic in World War II. Nowadays, sporadic cases of Parkinson's may find. Now, sometimes symptoms of the Parkinson's, they are observed after treatment with phenothiazine group of tranquilizer, because these groups of tranquilizers, they block dopaminergic receptors, mainly D2 receptors. Also, symptoms of the Parkinson's, they are observed when we are injecting the drug MPTP. Full form of it is methyl 4-phenyl tetrahydropyridine. This MPTP is converted into MPP, that is methyl phenyl pyridinium, by the astrocytes. And this drug produces symptoms of the Parkinson's disease. What is the pathology of Parkinson's disease? As we have discussed, that there is loss of dopaminergic fibers in the nigrostriatal pathway. When dopaminergic fibers are lost in this pathway, there is imbalance between excitation and inhibition. Excitatory inputs, they are corticostriate fibers from cerebral cortex to corpus striatum, and inhibitory, they are nigrostriatal fibers. Because of loss of this inhibitory dopaminergic fibers, the balance is disturbed. And normally, inhibitory output from the basal ganglia, that is kept in check by this inhibitory dopaminergic fibers. And because of loss of this dopaminergic fibers, the circuit gets disturbed, and that results in various symptoms of the Parkinson's disease. Treatment. As we have discussed, Parkinson's is a neurodegenerative disease, and it is due to degeneration of dopaminergic neurons. Therefore, symptoms of the Parkinson's, they show improvement when we administer levodopa, that is the precursor of dopamine. Now, why levodopa, not the dopamine? Because dopamine cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. So when we give levodopa, this levodopa can cross blood-brain barrier, and this levodopa is converted to dopamine in the dopaminergic neurons of the brain. Along with levodopa, L-dapranil is given. Now, what is the mechanism? Why do we require to give L-dapranil? Because L-dapranil is inhibitor of monoamine oxidase. This monoamine oxidase causes destruction of dopamine. So, L-dapranil prevents destruction of dopamine inside the basal ganglia by the enzyme monoamine oxidase. And therefore, the action of dopamine is longer. Treatment includes pallidotomy, in which lesion is made in the internal segment of the globus pallidus or in the subthalamic nucleus. This helps to restore the output balance towards normal. Along with this pallidotomy, electrodes are implanted, and these electrodes are attached to subcutaneous stimulators, and high frequency current is administered. This high frequency current disturbs the circuit temporarily. Another mode of treatment is dopamine secreting tissue. It is implanted either in or near the basal ganglia. For example, patient's own adrenal medullary tissue or carotid body, they secrete dopamine. They can be used, but long-term results are not satisfactory. Instead of that, fetal striatal tissues can be used as a transplantation, and their results are better than adrenal or carotid body transplant. Another mode of treatment is genetic therapy, which is under trial. So, modes of treatment includes levodopa, surgical treatment, that is pallidotomy, as well as along with that, electrodes are implanted and they are attached with subcutaneous stimulator. Implantation of dopamine secreting tissues either in or near the basal ganglia. So this is all about Parkinson's disease. Thank you. Thanks for watching. For more such videos, subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon.